Hey, it's Kwesi Smith here, managing partner of the Smith & Green Attorneys at Law. And I just wanted to stop and talk to you a moment about something that occurs quite often. In fact, there's a great possibility that this will happen if you're ever charged with a crime. And our clients, that are facing criminal charges, they often ask this question: should I take this plea deal or not? They've offered me this plea. Should I take it or not? Plea deals are a part of the criminal process. It's a tool used by prosecutors and the court. The court gets involved in the process sometimes in disposing of cases, making them go away prior to trial, because of course trials are very time consuming. They can be very lengthy depending on the kind of charges that you've been charged with, and also they require quite a deal of resources to deal with. And so if the prosecutor thinks they have all of the evidence that's necessary, which they should always, to get a conviction on the case, they'll offer you a plea deal to something lesser normally. And the question is, should I take the plea deal? Here's what you have to consider. Criminal records have a great impact on a lot of areas of your life. And I know it seems very insignificant. Oh, it's just shoplifting. Oh, it's just got caught with a joint. It wasn't much. I just got a ticket for spitting on the sidewalk. In some jurisdictions, that's still against the law to spit on the sidewalk. But criminal records have a great impact on your life, on your employment, your residence, your credit history, your family. If you end up in family court at some time, you got a conviction, or whether it's a misdemeanor or not, it could play a great deal of impact. College admission and making future plans for yourself. And so you have to consider everything before just taking a plea because you're scared of what could be. Well, there is always even something that could be, even if you accept the plea. I often tell my clients to consider, one, what is your exposure in the case? When I say your exposure in the case, I mean, how much evidence do they really have, and what can the impact of this be if you are actually convicted of it? In Arizona, we have mandatory sentencing statutes that if you're convicted of certain crimes, there's a mandatory sentence that the judge has to sentence you to. Of course, that can be minimized or mitigated. It can be aggravated or it can be maximized. But there's a range that the judge has to sentence you in, and the judge doesn't even have discretion about that unless probation is offered as a part of the offense. So when I say exposure, how bad can this go based on the evidence that they have? You have to consider that before determining whether or not to accept the plea. Let me say this to you. If you didn't do it, you didn't do it, okay? I would never tell somebody to accept the plea up front that they didn't do it. They weren't guilty of the crime because they weren't there. There's an alibi. That leads me into this. The second thing that you have to consider is, what defenses do you have that are available to you? If they said you were at the scene of this bank robbery and you know you weren't not there, okay, but we're not going to accept it a plea. We're going to find out a way to prove that you were not at the scene of that crime. And I've used cell tower ping. I've used text messages. I've used email addresses and Google Maps. And there's a plenty of ways you can use to prove that someone was not at the scene of a crime. To get charges dismissed against folks or get acquittals against folks. These are conversations that you must have with your attorney. Again, what are the defenses? What evidence do they have? If the evidence is bad, then maybe there's a shot at it that you can take. Defenses are concerned, like in Arizona, if you claim self-defense and you present evidence that shows that you were acting in self-defense, well, then the burden shifts back to the state to prove beyond a reasonable doubt that you weren't acting in self-defense on crimes where self-defense justification is warranted. So you have to look at all of these things. And again, the most important thing is, what does this plea deal entail? What are they asking me to plead to? Can this be set aside later? Because I don't want to be applying for jobs 5 years from now. And yes, it's only shoplifting a pack of gum from Walmart, but now I can't get a job at any position, a bank or anything, that's a position of trust. You have to look at everything. Sit and talk with your lawyer. A lot of prosecutors offer plea deals early on, before you ever get a chance to even talk to a lawyer really good about your case, about your evidence. And so get with a lawyer, be it a public defender or you retain private counsel like us, get with a lawyer soon. Talk about the case before you start accepting plea deals and all of that stuff. because you have to really figure out if this is the right thing to do or not. We're more than happy to go over your case with you. Give us a call or some other competent attorney so that you get the best possible outcome for your case.